Shalom! Greetings to all viewers all across the world. I'm Dr. Swanim Solmi.
I'm Dr. Tavi Selim Solmi.
Together, we are the Solmis. This is the arena of the supernatural. Where supernatural is always natural. You will see the wonders, and you have been blessed throughout all these weeks that have gone by. Yes. I know you are following our program.
Amen. Just to remind you, 2016 is the year of Jubilee.
Yeah.
Everything being paid back. Mm. Restoration. So we,
the captives are free.
Yeah.
Debt cancellation.
And we believe that you are partaking in the anointing that we have as we celebrate Jubilee in the name of Jesus. And we'll be going to our collaboration.
Something that you have never been. Never
last
been.
Time. Last time we collaborated. And again, we are doing it again. I'll be preaching and my husband will be preaching. And I'll be preaching on conflict resolution. Lately, you've been speaking more on relationships.
Yeah, they're still going to hear about the relationships.
Yeah.
Yeah, two more weeks that are coming.
And he's preaching on like powerful stuff. Sermons. Yeah. We have been tested when it comes to relationships. We're not just preaching something that we read on books, even though we do read books, we read the word of the Lord, but we've been tested and we came out victorious.
Amen.
So I'll be speaking on conflict resolution, like how you can resolve conflict. I know as children of God, we are taught just keep quiet.
Faka amanzi emlonyeni.
Just ignore.
Put water in your mouth.
Don't say anything.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is when we keep quiet, we don't confront. Most of the time we speak to other people and you'll find that people are looking at each other with hate, but talking to other people, gossiping. But can't we change that culture? Like confront the things that we need to confront.
Doesn't kill. Straight talk breaks no friendship.
Yes. And yes, it doesn't break any. It's painful, but it's needed.
You see, when we're doing it in love,
mm.
love covers all things.
Yeah. Take the truth and cover it in love, and then it becomes something else.
Solution.
And then Dr. Swanee, what were you saying?
I was speaking about the cross. I mean, the relationship, the cross that brought the relationship between us and God,
mm-hmm.
and relationship between us as human beings.
Mm-hmm.
And also it has made us to be able to deal with our past,
yeah.
so that we can focus on Jesus Christ. When we are in Jesus Christ, we are a new creature.
Mm-hmm.
So there are things that can happen through the cross. If we don't go back to the cross, we will be moody. Mm-hmm. We will pray whenever we want to pray.
Mm-hmm.
We will read the Bible whenever we want to
read the Bible.
We will give tithes whenever it suits us. You see, these are the principles that we need to live by. When you live by principle, you focus yourself, you commit yourself, then you get the results.
Amen. Results are good. Let's go to the preaching and let's hear the word of the Lord.
May God bless you.
Driving a car is very easy. Can I see the drivers in the house? Can you confirm with me that driving a car is easy? It is easy. Who can say it's difficult? It's very easy. But guys, you remember the first time we were learning to drive.
Oh!
The thought of getting in the car.
I would even ask my husband to accompany me.
Because I was scared. Before I could even move from my house, I was thinking about the steep hill that is at section B, at Inand. How am I going to climb that steep hill? And I
said,
no, let me leave the car, let me take taxis. But it helped me to have somebody who was encouraging me to say, no, drive, you'll be fine. And as I drove, it became easy through time. And I'm asking myself now,
what was really giving me a
because this thing is easy, but I had to have a relationship with the car, step by step, slow by slow, and overcome the fears and drive in when I make mistakes. I used to fear taxi men. I didn't want to drive where taxi men were driving. Because as we all driving, there are those who drive recklessly. You fear them, even if they are good drivers, because they have a reputation. Amen. So if you're scared of driving, I encourage you. It's nothing. It's easy. Likewise, conflicts. We are never taught how to deal with conflicts. To resolve conflicts amongst one another. Our parents were never taught. And surely they never taught us. We learned to defend ourselves. To make means. Amen. But today we are going to learn about conflict resolution. Because if we don't learn it, we will always have a problem. Amen.
Amen.
The truth is, we love one another. And the truth is, the people that are not getting along are not bad people. It's just that the chemistry sometimes is not right. But they are not bad people. Have you ever seen a wife and a husband? They are a wonderful couple on their own individually. But they don't get along. And you ask yourself, what is wrong? Because I love Mrs. Shays. And I love Mr. Shays. They are unique. They are wonderful. They are good people. But they don't get along. Another one is shouting at the other one. They almost kill each other. And the other one says how bad the other one is. But me, I see a wonderful couple. And I say, ooh, if I want to be someday, I want to be like Mrs. Shazy. What is wrong? Amen. Amen. You see somebody for the first time. This person has wonderful attributes. Characteristics. This person is wonderful. This is the person I need in my life. Because I can see if I can have this person. 1, 2, 3 will be taken care of. Once we work together, all hell breaks loose. But I love this person. But when we come together, becomes difficult. Is that person a bad person? Not necessarily. But the chemistry and the ability to get along, it's a challenge. Amen. Let's go to Matthew chapter 5, verse 9.
Asien gu Matthew chapter 5, verse 9.
Then I will appreciate if I can have a Bible reader that is just sitting next to the microphone. Yes, you can read.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 9. From the Anje, babusisiwe abalamulayo ngokuba bayakuthiwa abantwana bakaNkulunkulu.
Amen. Blessed are the peacemakers, because they will be called children of God. I like to read the Message Bible, the Message version. It says, you are blessed when you can show people how to cooperate.
If you are able to work with people
instead of compete and fight, that's when you discover who you really are and your place in God's family. You are blessed when you cooperate with people instead of fighting with them and competing with them. And then the original says, blessed are the peacemakers, because they will be called children of God. Can we dispute that, Bazalwan? Dispute.
Oppose.
That we are, if you are a peacemaker, then you are called a child of God. Then it means if you don't make peace, you are not called a child of God. Then there's something that you should run after. But most of the time we withdraw. We are different in dealing with conflict. And there is a reputation in the church that we don't deal with issues. We avoid them and we speak about them under the carpet. But we don't address them. But every time Jesus will confront issues. He confronted Peter straight and sharp. He also confronted, who is this? Judas. Straight and front.
You see Jesus? The way he was doing things.
He said, the one who's going to betray me is sitting amongst us. And you will see him, because we will eat in the same cup. And he says to Peter, get away, you Satan. But these days, we don't say anything, but you can go to somebody else and say how hurt and offended you are by somebody else. But it's very difficult to call and confront someone. Why? Many reasons. But the main one is because maybe we are fearful to hurt them. We are fearful what they can say. We are fearful that we can take that conflict and make it bigger. What if I go there and then she just overpowers me? After all, she will never listen. She is a doctor. She will never hear what I have to say. And then you ended up suffering alone. Maybe it's true that person will never hear what you have to say, but maybe it's better to give it a try. But if you don't know how to do it, and if you don't have the skills, and if you don't know how to drive that car of conflict, you might end up taking the car to the trees. That is why we always have fear when we start driving. We are scared to make accidents. We are scared to make mistakes. But the more you do it, the more you gain confidence. So by this lesson that I'm going to teach you, we are not saying we are perfect. Even myself, I'm still walking this journey. But as I'm teaching you, I am also learning. Can I encourage you, Bazalwane? Don't stop teaching something just because you feel you are not perfect. The more you teach it, the more it will perfect you. Because the word of God is a two-edged, is a double-edged sword. As it cuts through you, it also cuts through me. As you speak to people, it also challenges you as a preacher. Because when you preach something that you do not do, it's like you are putting yourself in a spotlight, and people will be looking at you as a teacher. So in a position wise, you move and go to another level where you become a teacher and you start challenging yourself, because you cannot fail when you are a teacher. You must always have answers. I know we are living in a generation where people are teaching what they don't do. But I believe, as we are all here, we have this eagerness for God to work in our lives. For me, I have this desire that God make me a woman that will be an example to other women. Make me a limelight. Make me to be an example. Give me courage to excel in the things that I've been failing to do. And I believe this is the desire we all have. Amen. Amen.
Maybe
you also have moods. You pray when you feel like
this.
You don't pray because you're supposed to pray. That's on its own, it's moods. God is in trouble with people that have moods. People that pray when they feel like this.
Ama Muslim na Majuda athandaza ngesikhathi esithize. Either ayathandi noma awamthandi, awana choice yokuba nama moods.
Muslim and the Jews, they pray at the certain time whether they like it or not.
Kodwa thina ma Christ
but us as Christians, we have moved. And they will pass without you even praying. You'll even fail to even bless the food.
Ukhumbule ngoba ama feelings akho ebemnandi ngalolo suku yanuka kamnandi lokudla okudla bese uthi siyabonga Nkosi.
You will remember because there is a good smell and the food was delicious, then you say thank you Lord.
Mawuphuza le tiyele emnyama amamuthi akho amabi kakhulu.
When you drink that black tea, then your moods, then you become
masa kunamasala danyana sekunezinto ezithize ezimnande. Oh baba siyakubonga kubusise lokudla ubusise nezandla ezikwenzile.
When there are salads and there is good.
Musise kusangena nasemzimbeni wethu Nkosi.
Blessed Lord, even the one who have gained.
Kodwa ngalesikhathi utsha lo yajeqe lo yana.
But the time you were eating that dumpling.
Azange ukhumbule.
You didn't remember.
Amamuthi wonke lawo.
Those are all moods.
Thandaza mawuthanda.
You pray when you feel like it.
Ubonga mawuthanda.
Give thanks when you feel like it.
Amamuthi lawo.
That on its own is.
UNkulunkulu uyavelelwa ngoba lezi zinto lezi siyamxaka.
God is in trouble because this thing are.
Kodwa ngoba uNkulunkulu akanankingi.
But because it's God, he doesn't have a problem.
Ungakhuluma namhlanje ntambama.
I am speaking today in the afternoon.
Bangizwa bazala.
Is the church with me?
Uthando lune commitment.
The love have commitment.
Liyayibophezela.
It have commitment.
Ngizomthanda uMazondi.
I will love Mazondi.
Ayi ngiyazizwa ngiyamthanda noma ngiyithandi kodwa ngiyamthanda.
Whether I feel like it or I don't.
Ngamkhetha ngimthanda.
I chose
him. Ngiyomthanda sizehlukaniswa ukufa.
I will love till death do us apart.
Yabona ngayimisela.
You see our serious about
engqondweni yami nasemzimbeni wami ukuthi ngiyomthanda. And ngisamthanda.
And I still love him.
Ngimthanda kakhulu kunaqala ngosuku engambona ngalo.
I love her
uthando lwami luyakhula.
Ngifuna ukuba nezenzo ingaphezulu kweza izolo ekumthandeni kwami.
Nonkulunkulu kanjalo uthando lwami luyakhula. Ngambukela imoli ngathi kuhle simkhonzele emoli enxanxatheleni yeyitolo.
Kuthi kushisa KFC kube kushisa indumiso ngala.
Ngobani uthando lami
the more ngimthanda
the more ngikhula
abanye bathi mabekhula
eminyakeni uthando liyancipha
kanti uthando liyamachuwa
yabonga sikhathi limachuwa
ingale sikhathi linganaki kakhulu imizwa
lunaka kakhulu iqiniso
ukuthi lo muntu useme nami for 12 years
ngingamenzelani
bakithi
ukuze abone ukuthi washada indoda
eright man.
Hayi bonga noma ngiyazwakala.
Do you hear me?
Iyazwakala le.
Do you hear this?
So bengisasho ke bazalwane ukuthi imithetho yeyishumi yakhelwa thina.
So I was saying 10 commandments are for us. For it to guide us.
Igade thina ukuthi sikwazi ukuhlalisana.
Guide us to be able to live with the child.
Ukwazi ukukuthanda noma ungathandeki.
To be able to love you even if you are not.
Ngibekezelele noma ungabekezelele.
To be patient with you even though it's difficult to be patient.
Ukuthi yazi abanye abantu baphila ngeyithelo zikamoya ezibolekiwe.
Others live with the fruits of the spirit that have been borrowed.
Ewaphelu amen masengikhuluma nje. Ngiqinisile bazalwane.
I'm telling the truth.
Abanye baphila ngeyithelo zikamoya ezibolekiwe, akuzona ezabo ezibolekiwe.
Others they tend to borrow the fruits of the spirit is not theirs.
Ubona ubabudokotela ethanda uNkosikazi wakhe na waliboleka lolo thando lokuthanda uNkosikazi.
As you can see doctor
Marcel hlangana nezinto alisebenza ulitshinga phansi bese ethi kodwa mina ngishalo ngikwazi ukwenza lento le ayenzeki lento le
he just leave it outside and said I cannot do this
bese isikhathi ubona abanye abantu benza into bese uyayitsheleka leyo nto bese uyazama ukuyenza bese uyabona ukuthi ayifithi kuwena
other time you tend to see other people doing that
lento iyafana nento eyenziwe uDavide bamnikeza izingubo yika Saul
it's like what
bethu akalwe ngazo
David given the
ungalwe ngeinto ezibolekile
don't fight with something that have been borrowed
sebenzisa izinto zakho
use your own
ngendlela yakho ngesimilo sakho ngenqondo yakho so ilokho engikushoyo ngezinto zabantu ezibolekiwe
so that's what I'm saying with other people's possession that have been borrowed
ngikhuluma nomuntu wesifazane bakithi
I'm talking to a woman
okay
ngitshe
ukuqala
I said firstly
umthethe ushumi igade thina
the 10 commandments are guiding
okwesibili okunye
second thing
izolo lami
my yesterday
lingenza ukuthi imithethe yishumi
it can make the 10 commandments
ingabe right
for it not to be right
ingabonakale iyakhelwe mina engathi yakhela ukucindezela mina
for it not to be seen as if it's made for me but it's as if it's made to suppress me
bangizwa bazalana
amen
iyazwakala leyo
do you hear that
imthethe yishumi
the 10 commandments
kungenzeka
it's my being
usathana iveze
the devil to show
njengokuthi yakhela ukuthi icindezele mina
as a way to oppress
kanti zogada bani
but it's here to guide
me ifuna ukungitshela ukuthi ngikumoya noma ngisenyameni
it wants to tell me whether I'm in the spirit or I'm in the flesh
mangabe usenyameni
when you're in the flesh
inzima imthetho
eyishumi the 10 commandments are
kodwa mangabe ukumoya
but when you're spirit
uyayigcinekela ungabonanga ukuthi igcinekile
it just happened automatically without you being aware
lalela
listen
kwafika umpriest
a priest came
wabona umsamariya elimele
and so
I mean wabona umuntu elimele
a person that is injured
wadlula
and then he paused
kwafika umlevi
and the levite
wafika umuntu elimele
and saw a person that had been injured
wadlula
and then he paused
kwazofika umsamariya
and the samaritan
wabona umuntu olimele
and saw an injured person
wamlungisa
and rectify the person
wamsulisa isilonda negazi wamkebelisa imbongolo yakhe wamthatha wahamba naye wamfunela isibhedlela wamlalisa esibhedlela wamkhokhela wathenye ngizoyikhokha mase ngibuya mayesephilile
and then the other one I will pay after his rights and when he's alive and
uJesu seyabuza
and Jesus is asking
usethi ubani owenze kahle
say who did good
kulaba abantu about 3
abanga
about 3
3 people
sebe yasho bathi no umsamariya olungileyo
it's the righteous samaritan
umsamariya olungileyo
the righteous samaritan
akayena nomjuda
he's not even a jew
abantu ababajuda umpriest
the jew is the priest
nomlevi
and the levite
and ababona nje amajuda nje ordinary jews but ba kuma position aphezulu kwi religious organization
they are not just ordinary jews but they are in high position
basondelene noNkulunkulu
they are also in line with
bathandazela abantu kuNkulunkulu
they pray to people to god
kodwa basenabo ubudlelwane noNkulunkulu sibona kanjani ukuthi abasenabo ubudlelwane noNkulunkulu bajahuka esontweni kodwa umuntu oyezulwini uyafa la bajahuka uyothandazela laba abasesontweni kodwa lo abambona la endleleni uyafa uJesu ufundisa thina
Jesus is trying to give us a lesson
ukuthi sike sibe onomasonto ngalendlela ukuthi sikhohlwe ukuveza ivangeli kulabantu abafayo lapha eminyango ngoba sishaya kuyezulwini esontweni I mean
a church goers in a way that we neglect those people that are out
uyekela ukusiza umuntu ozobona ivangeli mayikubuza ethi ubani kodwa uthi ngumntwana kaNkuluNkulunkulu
you neglect to show the gospel to a person that wants to see it
uyekela ivangeli ukwenza ivangeli ngoba ujahu kuyohlala nje ulalela ukushunya yezo
you neglect to show the gospel because you want to be preached to
so uJesu uyabuza uthi ubani owenze kahle
so Jesus is asking who did
uthi umsamariya olungile
and they said the righteous
umpriest akenzanga kahle
the priest didn't do
umlevi akenzanga kahle kube umsamariya olungile ongasiyena ngisho nomjuda ngamanye amazwi uJesu uthini
in other words what Jesus is saying
uthi kuyofika isikhathi la ibandla lami lingenamizwa seliphelele ubusawoti balo
it says that it will reach a point where my church doesn't have any feeling and they lost
umuntu ekwazi ukudlula umuntu how much more kumzalwane ngoba akambhekanga nokumbheka mhlawumbe umza ihamente lakhe leli
if a person is able to pass through the brethren maybe it's a fellow brethren
bana mabazalwane
is the church with me
5 minutes left
mzuzemhlane sishote
Na indaba yami.
Yes, my story.
Izolo.
Yesterday.
Izolo.
The yesterday.
Uma ungadilanga nalo.
If you never dealt with it.
Lento leyo uNkulunkulu asinikeze yona.
What the Lord have given us.
Okuyimthethe yishumi.
Which is the 10 commandments.
Ngeke isebenze kahle kuwena.
It won't work right with you.
Ngeke isebenze kahle.
It won't work right with you.
Inkinga ingakho sinenkinga nobudlelwana namhlanje.
That's why we have a problem with the relationship.
Ingoba sixakwe izolo lethu.
It's because we are troubled by our yesterday or past.
Ubaba akangithandanga kahle.
My father didn't love me.
Umama akangithandanga kahle.
My mother did not love me.
Ngahlukumezeka.
I was abused.
Ngahlukunyezwa, ngashawa.
I was hurt.
Ngangithukwe ekhaya.
At home they sweated me.
Babengixoshe ekhaya.
They will chase me.
Angizangithola ukudla ekhaya.
I didn't receive food. Angizangithola
ithuba lokuyofunda.
I didn't receive an opportunity to go.
Njalo uhlala unento ongokhala ngayo.
Every time you are mourning, you're always mourning.
Kunini la uzo enjoy khona namhlanje?
When are you going to enjoy the today?
Uliyekele izolo ngoba ngeke usakwazi ukulishintsha.
And leave the past because you can't change it.
Into ilokho inkinga namhlanje yama yebudlelwano.
The problem with the relationship today?
Izolo lethu.
It's our past.
Ngiyamzonda umuntu wesilisa ngenxa lomuntu wesilisa ohlangane naye izolo.
I hate the man because of this man that you made.
Wagrape wakuthelela ngengculazi.
That raped you and infected you.
Manje usuzonda wonke umuntu wesilisa.
Now you hate each and every man.
Hey, asifani sonke.
We are not all the same.
Lo kwenze kabi izolo.
The one who did that
akafani
nami. Is not like me.
Mina ngomunye umuntu.
I'm another person.
Kodwa manje ungrate ngalo.